done again with yet another example of how you can use the new voice conversation functionality with ChatGPT. I'm going to go back to an experiment I did just when ChatGPT 4 itself launched earlier this year in 2023. My daughter, who you can see there, was studying for her SATs exams, which is an exam kids in the UK do around the age of 10, 11 to test their knowledge and how they've been doing in school so far. She was doing really great on all of the subjects with the exception of maths, where she was achieving about 50% grades on her mock papers, which is okay. I'm not a pushy parent, but I just wanted her to do well when she moved into high school. So we worked out the sort of the problems that she was having with maths, the areas she was struggling with. I tried to help, but I realized, just like Mr. Incredible, why did they change math? Because the way maths is done these days is completely different to how I learn. So I set about in sort of April, May 2023, learning how to write prompts, really, and learning how to sort of use prompt craft to create a virtual maths tutor for Daisy to guide her through the areas she was struggling with. So I fed in information like she was doing a SAT, she was failing on these sort of subjects, or not doing as well as she wanted to on these subjects within that. Fed in some personal information, not too personal, but things like that she loves dogs, that she loves a laugh. And basically created a virtual tutor. I'm going to reignite that virtual tutor today, but using the new voice conversation functionality, so you can get an idea of how you also might be able to create your own tutors to expand your learning on different areas in life. Let's give it a shout.
It's me, Izzy, back for another round of maths fun. Ready to get into some more long division and multiplying fractions, Daisy?
I am indeed.
Awesome, Daisy. Let's dig right in. Last time we touched on long division and started diving into multiplying fractions. Today, let's really focus on those fractions, shall we? Multiplying fractions. Imagine you have 3/4 of a doggy treat and you want to give your furry friend half of what you have. To find out how much to give, you'd multiply the fractions frac 3, 4, and frac 1, 2. Here's how it works. Multiply the top numbers, the numerators, together, and then do the same for the bottom numbers, the denominators. So frac 3, 4, 1, 2 equals frac 3 times 1, 4 times 2, which gives us frac 3, 8 of the treat for your pup. How's that? Making sense so far?
Yeah, but when you keep saying frac, it confuses me.
Ah, my apologies for the confusion, Daisy. Let's keep it simple. To multiply fractions, just multiply the top numbers together and then do the same for the bottom numbers. So if you have 3/4 of a doggy treat and want to give half to your friend, you'd multiply the top numbers 3 and 1 to get 3. Then you'd multiply the bottom numbers 4 and 2 to get 8. So you'd end up with 3/8 of the treat for your furry friend. Is that clearer?
Yeah, but I'm sure my dog would love 8/8 of the treat.
Haha, I bet your dog would. Who wouldn't want a whole treat, right? But hey, in the world of fractions, sometimes we've got to share. Feeling more confident about multiplying fractions now? Ready to try a practice question?
Yeah, go for it.
You have 5/6 of a bag of dog treats, and you want to share 2/3 of it with your neighbor's pup. How much of the bag would you end up giving away?
I've got 5/6 of a bag of treats, and I want to give 2/3 away to my friend. Is that right?
Exactly, Davey. You've got 5/6 of a bag of dog treats, and you want to give 2/3 of what you have to your neighbor's pup. So how much would you end up giving away?
So we'd go 2 times 5 is 10.
That's right. You've got the numerator down. Now what about the denominator? What do you get when you multiply 6 and 3?
You get 18.
Spot on, Daisy. So you'd end up giving away 10, 18 of the bag of treats to your neighbor's pup. Well done. Ready for me to chat with your dad about how today's lesson went?
Can you just give me one quick test on one of the other subjects that I'm struggling with, please, Izzy?
Of course, Daisy. Let's switch gears and tackle a long division question.
Ooh.
Long division test. You have 126 tennis balls and you want to distribute them equally among 9 dogs. How many tennis balls would each dog get? Give it a go and let me know your answer.
I would normally do this in a spreadsheet.
Ah, spreadsheets can be super helpful for quick calculations, but for this exercise, try doing it the old-fashioned way. How many times does 9 fit into 126 without going over?
14.
Well done, Daisy. You're right, 9 fits into 126 exactly 14 times. Maths is all about practice, and you're doing great so far. All right, switching over to chat with your dad. Hi, Phil. Daisy's making good progress. She's getting more comfortable with multiplying fractions and was close on the long division example. With some more focused practice, especially in fractions, she'll be well on her way to acing her SATs.
Great. Can you make sure that you do give her quite a bit of focus on those multiplying fractions next time? Because I'm a bit worried about that. Her multiplying fractions is better than her dad's, though. And also, don't forget to keep it light with the odd joke here and then.
Absolutely, Phil. I'll make sure to put extra focus on multiplying fractions in our next session. And no worries, I'll keep the mood light with some dog-themed jokes to keep the learning fun. Daisy's doing well, and I'm confident she'll continue to improve, especially in those tricky fractions.
Brilliant. Do you want to finish the video with a little dog joke?
Of course. To wrap things up, why did the dog sit in the shade? Because he didn't want to be a hot dog. Hope that brings a smile to both of you. Looking forward to our next lesson.